We're gonna take a cruise in the AEV Brute. It's a beautiful Sunday here in Texas. The doors lock automatically once you get rolling. I think you can set that in the computer. Just put new tires on it. The other ones had plenty of tread, but they were aged out. I like fresh tires every 5 years. It's really pretty quiet inside. It's well insulated. It's got these removable T-tops for the summertime. And the Hemi gives it just really good drivability. It's got a good stereo. And I did the PSC steering upgrade only because with 37-inch tires, you're right on the borderline of the stressing the factory power steering system, the box and the pump. And the pump was actually starting to just make a little bit of a whining noise. So I took it to them. I got a ported heavy duty box, ram assist hydraulic arm, which also serves as a steering stabilizer. And then they recommended a very heavy duty drag link system. It's made by, drawing a blank, something like Aztec or something. It's in the description. All those parts are brand new. Just been driven just a few miles. That and the tires. And I've got a couple other Jeeps. This one is one of my favorites, but it's almost too nice to take it off-road, so I really have never taken it off-road. Drivability, it doesn't lug. They also put the TerraFlex larger brake system on it, calipers, rotors, so you can stop it. And really, AEV's goal in their trucks is to drive and perform as good as factory, but lifted with big tires. And I think the only place they missed their mark was on the steering. 35-inch tires, the factory steering is fine. But you get up to 37s, and it's really good to beef that system up. Get up here on the freeway. Looking for the last of the AEVs, and one of the few that had the 37 inch tire upgrades along with the Hemi. This is a good one for sure. It's a keeper. It's a solid investment, something you keep for years, have fun with it, and it's going to maintain most of its value. And if you ordered one back in the day and had it built with this F1 interior and all the upgrades that this has, it was over $100,000 in 2017. Was quite a bit of money. You kind of had to be a player to buy one, and now it represents a really tremendous value. The current miles are 12,186. Overkill. If a half ton truck could pull a trailer, I want a one ton truck. Overkill lasts a long time. But yeah, this is as close to a no pick double cab Jeep that you're probably likely to find, unless somebody put one away with 1,000 miles. But I've bought stuff that was older with super low miles, and there's always challenges. I bought a truck that had 800 miles and the fuel system was bad. Ethanol got in there and ate up the fuel pump. I had to replace some injectors, and it was basically a brand new truck, but it was 9 years old. So it's good to get out and run them a little bit. This one, I have done just that. And I've kept the oil changed, I've maintained it, and I just haven't driven it a lot. And that's why it only has 12,187 miles. Well, I hope I'm not boring you too bad, but if you're a serious buyer on this Jeep, you want to know everything there is to know about it, I'm going to pull up here and I'll end the video. This is such a fun Jeep. I am gonna miss it. Even on this road that's kind of beat up from the big trucks, this thing tracks really straight. And part of it is the long wheelbase. Really makes it ride nice. It's a great machine. Temperature gauge runs right in the middle. I'm pulling up here to the shop. I'm gonna hop in the back seat and turn off the old GoPro. Good luck with your bids. I'm Bronco Bob, wishing you happy trails.